Hi everybody, and welcome to this APC Expert webinar on inclusive environments. This is actually a request from one of our subscribers, Ajish, who says, "Hi David, can you do a short video on inclusive environments?" Well Ajish, thanks for that comment, and here you are. Here's a quick bite-sized mandatory competency webinar on that subject. Environments should not present people with barriers with their enjoyment of that activity or participation of activities within it. Looking at what are inclusive environments, inclusive environments enable everyone to access the opportunities an environment presents regardless of their age, disability, ethnicity, gender, gender expression, faith, or economic circumstance, including when they are travelling with children, or carrying luggage, or shopping. I'm hoping what you're seeing here are links to the five RICS ethical standards: act with integrity, always provide a high standard of service, act in a way that promotes trust in the profession, treat others with respect, and take responsibility. I'm based and practice in the United Kingdom, so let's look at the legislation in this country. The Equality Act 2010 is the key legislation relating to equality and accessibility in the UK. It replaced a range of previous anti-discrimination laws, including the Sex Discrimination Act, the Race Relations Act, and the Disability Discrimination Act. If you're not based in the UK and doing your APC, please look up and please understand local equality legislation in your area of practice. There are other legal requirements in the UK that need to be considered, such as Part M of the Building Regulations. And this sets out the minimum accessibility requirements which should be met under the Building Act 1984. Also, the National Planning Policy Framework identifies the need for planning policies and decisions to create places that are safe, inclusive, accessible, and promote health and well-being. And the public sector equality duty requires in the UK that public authorities consider how their facilities or services affect people who are protected under the Equality Act. Let's look now on application of these requirements. The Equality Act states that there should be reasonable access given. Permanent and semi-permanent disabled access systems do need to comply with Building Regulations Part M, any technical standards, and the National Planning Policy Framework. Now, if you're doing level 2 of this competency, you need to apply your knowledge in order to deliver accessible and inclusive environments. And level 3 is giving reasoned advice on these concepts, on how they can deliver accessible and inclusive environments. One thing that's worth mentioning is I've seen in some APC candidate submission them refer to DDA compliance. Now, there is no such thing anymore as DDA compliance. As we've already said, the Disability and Discrimination Act was replaced in 2010 by the Equality Act. However, we've mentioned reasonable access, but this still remains open to interpretation. So at levels 2 and 3, it's how you practice giving practical advice, which can be open to interpretation. So if you're doing levels 2 and level 3, be very clear on your understanding and on the reasons behind your decision making. Thanks very much for watching. If you've enjoyed this video, please subscribe to this YouTube channel, and please also check out our APC Pass courses on Udemy.